Hey guys, welcome back. Today's video is going to be a bit different than previous build breakdowns. I'm starting a new series where we'll be breaking down a weapon of your choice. I will focus on how it does in four different types of solo player content. The focus will be on solo dungeons, the Avalonian Roads, the Mist and Nightfall Abbeys, and finally, PvP. I will provide a couple of builds that you can use that will go well with this weapon, and depending on your economy, you can decide on which to go with. After I discuss how the weapon does, I will provide my thoughts and then assign a tier rating, with F being the lowest and S being the highest. Now before we get into the video, make sure to join the Discord community where we have over 400 members from all three regions, and I give away a 30-day premium every 2 weeks. Now, without further ado, let's get into the breakdown. So first things first, the Astral Staff is one of the new crystal weapons that has been released by SBI, and it falls under the Arcane tree. When it comes to the Arcane tree, I feel that it's very underrated. It provides a large amount of damage and mobility. Now, on top of that, your weapon's main ability provides some sort of crowd control, from displacing enemies to silencing them. So the Astral Staff brings that and more, with your main ability being Starfall. Starfall has a 9-meter radius that has a 6-second cast that does a huge amount of damage every 0.6 seconds. So you get a total of 10 ticks of damage. Now, before we break down how the weapon does in different content, let's go over the two builds I would recommend with the Astral Staff. Now, both builds can be used for all content. However, they do vary in price and playstyle. Now, the first build is the build I personally prefer. You'll go with the Mage Cowl. You can use Fire Breath for all PvE content and switch over to Force Field in PvP scenarios. For your chest piece, you will take the Mercenary Jacket for Bloodlust Sustain. You will go with Soldier Boots and take Rejuvenating Sprint. And for your cape, you could take the Thetford Cape. Now, the second build is a bit more expensive and plays around not being rooted or silenced. You can go with the Face Scale Hat for Hyper Focus to avoid being interrupted. Your armor piece will be the Cultist Robe for Levitate, which grants health and energy. And for your boots, you'll go with Royal Boot for Royal March to avoid being rooted and slowed. Now, if you plan to PvP a lot, you can take an Undead Cape. Alright, so let's talk about how this weapon does in solo dungeons. When it comes to solo dungeons, you want to make sure that you have enough damage to quickly clear mobs and kill the bosses. However, you also need to balance having enough sustain and energy to be efficient. Before going into solo dungeons, I thought that the weapon wouldn't do so well since it offers zero sustain. However, to my surprise, the Astral Staff held its own and was able to clear a tier 8 solo dungeon within 10 minutes. Now, that isn't the fastest, and there is always a cheaper option like the Druidic Staff, but for a DPS weapon that gives you the option to defend yourself from dungeon divers, it surprisingly does well. My goal was to quickly keep pulling in between packs, so I switched my passive to Energetic, where it returns energy from every auto attack. I never came close to running out of energy, which is a good thing. I was also able to round up mobs and AoE them down with Starfall and easily kill bosses. If you are wanting to do solo dungeons and not be bored with nature, then the Astral Staff is a great alternative as it does more than enough damage. I do recommend taking a Mercenary Jacket for some sustain and pairing it up with Soldier Boots for Rejuvenating Sprint. So overall, the Astral Staff paired with the right gear will do well in high tier solo dungeons. Now, let's talk about the Avalonian Roads. So great news, if you enjoy heading out to the roads to farm combat fame, unlock chests, or gather, you can also do this with the Astral Staff. I do recommend taking the Mercenary Jacket for sustain, however your Starfall will do huge amounts of damage and kill elite mobs. You will quickly fame up, receiving anywhere from 30 to 70,000 off of each elite mob. I was able to AoE down a couple of elites at the same time with not much issue. If you come across any other players, you can expect to hold your own. Now, since you'll be out in the black zone, this build can be a bit expensive due to the Astral Staff. So if you're going out there to only farm combat fame and fame credits, then nature will always be a better option. Overall, the Astral Staff can do what the nature staff does and provides you with a better option for PvP. So let's talk about the Mist and Nightfall Abbeys. The Mist and Nightfall Abbeys are where I've spent most of my time using the Astral Staff. So while in the Mist, I was easily able to clear camps for objectives, fight for chests, and solo spiders. I paired the Astral Staff with the Mage Cowl, Mercenary Jacket, and Soldier Boots. I've been keeping the Mercenary Jacket around for any needed sustain or PvP encounters. Now, let's talk about the Nightfall Abbeys. If you're looking to make combat fame and quickly clear areas for the hope of making millions of silver, this to me is one of the best weapons to quickly clear out a camp with one button. My main goal in the Nightfall Abbeys was to round up all the mobs and AoE them down, which worked well. Since I brought my Mercenary Jacket with me, it was easy to kill boss mobs for larger chests. Now, since the Astral Staff has a lot of utility with poke, mobility, and high damage, it does well in PvP encounters. Now, if you plan on just riding Nightfall Abbeys, which I always recommend you do since there is so much combat fame and silver to be made, it would be unwise not to. I would recommend altering the build a bit. I'm confident that you will still do more than enough damage to kill mobs if you switched over to like minor work boots and maybe an assassin jacket instead of a mercenary jacket. But overall, the Astral Staff has become my favorite weapon to use in the Nightfall Abbeys. Now, let's talk about PvP. So now when it comes to PvP, I think the weapon does a really good job and you can run two different types of builds with it that are both effective. Since it is an Arcane Staff, you get the poke damage from your Q or your first ability. You will also get large damage from Enigma Blade, which follows up with mobility. Now, when it comes to PvP, you do need to be aware of Starfall's cooldown. It has a decently long cooldown for a main ability. This means that you want to make sure that you're in range and will get the full benefit. When it's on cooldown, try to go back to kiting and poking until it's ready to come back up. I, on the other hand, like to roll the dice and use a cheaper build. This build does well in all other content like solo dungeons, rogues, mists, abbeys, and PvP. It's the first set that I mentioned, the one with the mage cowl, mercenary jacket, soldier boots, and the Thetford cape. Now, my final thoughts on the Astral Staff are that it's an overall great weapon. It takes everything that Arcane does well and adds a huge amount of damage for both PvE and PvP. It has become one of my overall favorite weapons to use since I'm a sucker for PvE content. Now, where would I place this on the tier list? I know this is the first of many, but once you play and get familiar with the Astral Staff, you'll see that it truly belongs in the S tier. Now, I do hope there aren't any nerfs coming soon since the cooldown on your Starfall brings some sort of balance to it. But alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the weapon breakdown. If you're interested in more Albion Online content, make sure to hit the like button, comment with which weapon you would like to see next, and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to join the Discord community and enter for a chance at winning 30-day premium giveaways every 2 weeks. Like always, stay epic, stay legendary, and I'll see you in the next one.